Now that we've defined the pollution burden and population characteristics, as well as the exposure, environmental effects, sensitive populations, and socioeconomic factors components, let's review the indicators for each of these components. First, it's important to define the term indicator as it's used in CalEnviroScreen. An indicator is a measure that specifies the level of something. In CalEnviroScreen, indicators provide a measure of environmental, socioeconomic, or health conditions. These indicator measures are calculated for each census tract across the entire state. The indicators help to present a broad picture of the burdens and vulnerabilities communities may face from pollution across the state. Certain criteria were applied to determine whether some data and possible indicators should be included in CalEnviroScreen. An indicator needs to provide a good measure of environmental or socioeconomic conditions in California. The indicator data also need to be publicly available, where possible. The information needs to have location information associated with it, such as an address, so that it can be assigned to a specific place in the state. The data need to be available across the entire state. And finally, the data must be as accurate and current as possible. CalEnviroScreen indicator data were collected from a variety of state and federal government sources. Many of the pollution burden indicators data come from different boards and departments within the California Environmental Protection Agency. Some additional data come from the US EPA and the California Department of Transportation. Data on population characteristics come from the US Census Bureau and the California Department of Public Health. Each of the four CalEnviroScreen components is made up of multiple indicators that contribute different types of information to the components. Now let's go into greater detail about the 20 indicators in the 3.0 version of CalEnviroScreen. First, we'll review the 7 exposure indicators. These provide information about potential contact with pollutants. Air concentrations of two important and common air pollutants, ozone and particulate matter 2.5, or PM2.5, come from air pollutants monitored by the California Air Resources Board. PM2.5 is particulate matter that is smaller than 2.5 microns in size. To compare, PM2.5 particles are about a quarter the size of talcum powder grains. Diesel PM emissions is another exposure indicator. Diesel PM contains hundreds of different chemicals, many of which are harmful to health. California has the biggest network of freeways in the country, and exhaust from cars and trucks is an important source of air pollution in much of the state. CalEnviroScreen includes a traffic density indicator, which uses information on the number of vehicles on the roads in an area. Toxic releases from facilities are sometimes detected in the air of communities. CalEnviroScreen uses information on types and amounts of chemicals released and how they move through the air. This information comes from the US EPA. While most drinking water in California meets health and safety standards, sometimes water can become contaminated with chemicals or bacteria. The drinking water contaminants indicator includes both natural and human sources of contamination. Here, average concentrations of contaminants were calculated from the water system and groundwater data to create the indicator. Finally, the pesticide use indicator measures the most toxic pesticides used for agriculture purposes. These 7 indicators represent different potential pollution exposures faced by people in California. Next are the 5 environmental effects indicators, which reflect adverse environmental conditions caused by pollutants. Cleanup sites, some of which are referred to as brownfields, are places with environmental contaminants that require remediation. Chemicals in buildings, soil, or water at cleanup sites can move into nearby communities through the air or by movement of groundwater. Hazardous waste facilities recycle, treat, store, or dispose of waste. many businesses generate hazardous waste that is transported to these facilities. Air, water, and soil can potentially be contaminated near these waste generators and facilities. Groundwater threats are chemicals which are often stored in containers on land or in underground tanks. Leaks from these containers or tanks can contaminate soil and pollute groundwater. When this happens, it may take many years to clean up the land and groundwater. When water bodies like streams, rivers, or lakes are contaminated by pollutants, they are considered impaired. These impairments are related to the amount of pollution in or near the water body. Impairments can restrict recreational use, harm wildlife habitat, and contaminate fish that people may eat. Solid waste facilities are places where household, commercial, and industrial waste are collected, processed, or stored. These include landfills and composting or recycling facilities. Most of these operations have permits, but some are illegal. Illegal sites and regulated facilities that do not follow the law can harm the environment and expose people to hazardous chemicals or nuisances. Next, we'll review the three population characteristics indicators. We'll start with indicators of sensitive populations. Asthma is a disease that affects the lungs and makes it sometimes hard to breathe. Asthmatics can be particularly sensitive to air pollution. 5 million Californians have been diagnosed with asthma at some point in their lives. This indicator uses the rate of asthma emergency department visits across the state. Cardiovascular disease refers to conditions caused by blocked or narrowed blood vessels that can lead to a heart attack or other heart problems. Heart attacks are the most common type of cardiovascular event. People who have had a heart attack can respond differently to the effects of pollution than people without heart disease. This indicator uses the rate of emergency department visits for heart attacks across the state. Babies who weigh less than 5.5 pounds at birth are considered low birth weight. Low birth weight babies may be more likely to develop asthma or other chronic diseases later in life, and can therefore be especially sensitive to pollution. Hospitals report data on where low birth weight babies are born. Finally, there are 5 indicators in CalEnviroScreen representing socioeconomic factors. Educational attainment means the highest level of education a person has completed. People with more education are more likely to have better health and live longer. The indicator is the percent of the population over age 25 with less than a high school education. Housing burden here refers to low-income households that are severely burdened by housing costs. The cost and availability of housing is an important determinant of health and well-being. Households with lower incomes may spend a larger portion of their income on housing. The indicator represents the fraction of low-income households that pay more than 50% of their income on housing. Linguistic isolation is a term used by the U.S. Census Bureau for the percent of limited English-speaking households. Linguistically isolated households may not hear or understand important information when there is an emergency, such as an accidental chemical release or spill. Income can affect health. For example, when people cannot afford healthy living and working conditions, nutritious food, or necessary medical care. Also, poverty can cause stress that weakens the immune system and may lead to an increased risk of illness from pollution. The poverty indicator is the percent of the population with income less than twice the federal poverty level. The U.S. Census Bureau counts people who are over 16 years old, out of work, and able to work as unemployed. Stress from long-term unemployment can lead to chronic illnesses such as heart disease and can shorten a person's life. People who are unemployed may lack health insurance or access to medical care. This concludes our review of indicators that make up CalEnviroScreen.